imperialism is an unequal system in which a more powerful country takes over a weaker country. Imperialistic motivations include economic gain, increase in power and military, nationalism, expansion, spreading of religions, and racial ideologies. This angel imperialism began in Great Britain and soon after spread to the United States, as both nations believe that they were both the best in the world and were strong enough to expand. The benevolent assimilation concept that President McKinley addresses specifically relates to the racial ideologies that helped drive the age of imperialism. Scientific racism and the civilizing mission, as well as the white man's burden, were all ideologies, supported by the fact that Europeans thought that they were superior racially and more civilized than the Asian Latin, American, and African people. This idea made the Europeans believe that they had a duty and an obligation to take over and help civilize the less civil inferior people. These ideologies became acceptable excuses and rationalizations for the age of imperialism. The US fought so hard for their independence from Britain that they needed a rationalization in order to turn around and do the same thing to other territories. This is how the phrase benevolent assimilation, which nearly means kinder caring integration, creates a positive twist on US imperialism of the Philippines. William McKinley was the 25th president of the United States and was known as one of the first modern presidents. He was elected as a Republican in 1897 with an extensive background in politics, first serving in the House of Representatives and then as the governor of Ohio before his presidency. During his 4.5-year term, he faced many issues dealing with foreign policy. These issues included a conflict with Spain over the Cuban Rebellion, which led to the Spanish-American War in 1898. Gabo was a Spanish possession and had gone through years of unrest and rebellion. The Cuban people wanted independence from the Spain, and the United States decided to support this house and send troops into Cuba demanding Spanish withdrawal. Spain responded to this by declaring war, and the Spanish-American War began in April of 1898. At the start of the war, the United States Navy was already much more superior than the Spanish. President McKinley had fought during the Civil War. He, with confidence, led them into the first battle in Cuba and then into the Philippines in the naval battle at Manila Bay. In only a couple of hours, the US Navy had defeated the Spanish and took the harbor at Manila. Hopes of keeping a US hold on the islands, a Filipino rebel leader, Emilio Aguinaldo, was allowed back into the Philippines after being exiled to Hong Kong. He was notorious for rebelling against Spanish rule and was able to rally more against the Spanish government. And on June 12, Aguinaldo proclaimed the independence of the Philippines from Spain. Although this was the case, President McKinley was still intent on controlling the Philippines under his power until Congress established a civil government for the island. This incongruity led to tension between the Filipino people and the US troops that were still occupying the country. By August 1898, the Spanish had been defeated by the United States at several air battles in the Pacific and Caribbean, and peace between the nations was declared after 2 months of negotiation. And the Treaty of Paris is signed between the US and Spain on December 10.
This treaty granted the US control over Guam, Puerto Rico, and the Philippines for $20 million. Due to the already heightened tensions between the US and the Philippines before the end of the war, President McKinley began to create a framework for military government in the Philippines. Even though the Treaty of Paris had not yet been ratified by the United States government, President McKinley was intent on keeping control over the Philippines until he believed they could govern themselves. In a proclamation intent for both the Filipino natives and the United States residents, President McKinley addressed the controversial issue at hand. President McKinley was known to be a persuasive speaker and was able to reach his audience through his compelling arguments. This proclamation became known as benevolent assimilation. In the proclamation, President McKinley declares that American government and military control will be extended throughout the islands, but guarantees that all Filipino natives still be entitled to their private rights and relations. He also explained that the U.S. is taking control in a friendly manner in a way of protecting the Filipino rights and returning their way of life back to normal as quickly as possible. He stated that those who welcome the supremacy of the United States will be protected, and those who do not will be treated with firmness if needed, but with a severity so far as possible. President McKinley refers to the famous phrase of benevolent assimilation by saying the ultimate goal is to gain the respect and affection of the Philippine nation as the U.S. integrates them into their society of free peoples with individual rights and liberties. This term benevolent means kind, compassionate, or in good nature, and proves how President McKinley is trying to convince both the U.S. and the Philippines that it is what the best for both nations. By bestowing the blessings of a good and stable government on the Philippines, President McKinley is targeting the imperialistic ideologies of the time period, which were that Europeans and Americans were more civilized than other nations, and as it is their duty to expand their nation in order to help civilize those nations that are not. General Elwell Utisem, who received proclamation, sat on it for a time in order not to antagonize the Filipinos further, for he knew that they were in a bad mood. Thus, he reasoned out, after a full considering the President's proclamation and the temper of the Tagalog with whom I was daily discussing political problems, and the friendly intention of the United States government towards them, I conclude that there were certain words and expressions therein, such as sovereignty, right of cession, and those which directed immediate occupation, though most admirably employed and tersely expressive of actual condition, might be advantageously used by the Tagalog War Party to incite widespread hostilities among the natives. The ignorant classes had been taught to believe that certain words at sovereignty, protection, had a peculiar meaning disastrous to their welfare and significant of future political domination, like that from which they had recently been freed. In order to comply with the President's order at the same time not to antagonize unduly of the Filipinos, Otis published McKinley's proclamation on January 4, 1899, with some amendments inserted in such a way as not to convey the meanings of the original sovereignty, protection, and right of cession. After the proclamation of benevolent assimilation, the Filipino population felt as though their declaration of independence had been completely ignored.